Good afternoon and happy weekend. Once again, this is your friend, brother, and humble servant, Roosevelt, saying hello, and hopefully everybody's having a wonderful day, and a wonderful day indeed. Happy June, happy weekend, and hopefully everybody is just living and enjoying life. If you are new to this channel or you just come across, you know what to do. Please go down and hit the subscribe button along with the bell icon. This way you'll be notified anytime I drop a brand new video right here on YouTube. Hopefully everyone is having a nice weekend. It's very warm here in the city of Chicago. You know, it's been in the 90s for the last couple of weeks, but or last couple of days, should I say. But I welcome it and I enjoy it because spring and summer is my favorite season. Whole lot coming up here in the city of Chicago for summer, and being here in the city of Chicago is kind of like a wonderful summertime destination, because I do believe that we do have the best summertime activities in all of the world. But that's not what I'm here to talk about on today. I'm here to bring you a little bit of news, some news that I meant to bring you earlier this week, only I've just been a little bit busy, I guess just relaxing, relating and releasing, you know, because all of us sometimes on YouTube, sometimes, you know, we need breaks too, and, you know, we do have lives outside of this here thing. But our story today takes us to Columbia, South Carolina. And it involves the shooting of a 14-year-old boy named Cyrus Carmack Belton by an Asian store owner, Rick Chow. And why? Because Rick Chow, who's the owner of this gas station in Columbia, South Carolina, falsely accused this young man, Mr. Belton, of shoplifting. And not only that, Mr. Chow has a bad reputation for doing these things before and shooting people and having all kinds of confrontations with customers. And so far, this happened on this past weekend, which was like last Sunday. And so far, he has been charged with murder, I believe. So right now, before I tell you exactly everything that I think about this particular story, I am going to bring you two news clips that's going to give some context and explain much more about what is going on. And then I'm going to come back with the rest of my commentary. And for everybody who knows me personally, you know that I am Roosevelt and I will not hold back. Please stay tuned for this clip or these clips.
Well, tensions are high tonight in Columbia, South Carolina, following the shooting death of a 14-year-old boy who was falsely accused of shoplifting. The gas station owner, who has a history of confrontations with customers, has been charged with murder. CBS's Nicole Skanga reports the community is fed up with yet another senseless loss of life.
Mourners protested outside this convenience store in Columbia, South Carolina, to remember 14-year-old Cyrus Carmack Belton, who was shot and killed the night before by the store owner. Hours later, rioters broke in, smashing merchandise and toppling shelves, angry over the loss of another young black life.
It was nothing but looting, just plain, pure looting. And what does that got to do with that 14-year-old?
According to the sheriff, on Sunday night, Belton took water bottles from a cooler before putting them back. The store's owner, 58-year-old Rick Chow, thought he was stealing. After they argued, Belton left and was chased down the street by Chow and his son. Then Chow observed what looked to be a firearm, pulled out his Glock, and fired one shot, hitting the 14-year-old in his back, piercing his heart. The boy's gun was found at the scene.
We believe he had a gun, but we don't believe he pointed at him, and that's the key to it.
Chow is now being held on one charge of murder. The sheriff says the store owner has a history of incidents involving customers, including a shooting in 2018, which was deemed self-defense and for which Chow was not charged. Nada Rutherford is not only the coroner who witnessed Belton's autopsy, but a community member and mother.
It is exhausting to see young black men being killed. It's exhausting to see any person being killed with gun violence.
Behind me, the gas station now boarded up. The 14-year-old's first name, Cyrus, spray painted on its walls. Now Belton graduated from the eighth grade just last week. His school principal describes him as full of light and humor.
Nora?
Nicole Skanga, thank you.
Tonight, a South Carolina convenience store left vandalized by angry protesters. The outrage over the death of a 14-year-old boy shot in the back and killed by the store's owner. Law enforcement officials say 58-year-old Rick Chow wrongly believed Cyrus Carmack Belton was shoplifting 4 bottles of water.
He did not shoplift anything. We have no evidence that he stole anything whatsoever. There was a verbal confrontation inside the convenience store. The victim went outside. He took off running.
Chow was arrested and charged with murdering the 8th grader after investigators say Chow chased him for several blocks before shooting him. One woman who didn't want to be identified telling our NBC affiliate she saw the deadly shooting firsthand.
That young man didn't have to die like that, but for me to witness that yesterday, like, I'm in fear for my own brother. And for any of the kids that's in my neighborhood, because these kids, they come outside all the time. They come to the store all the time.
Another witness describing the aftermath.
It's just sad. It's sad. If y'all have seen that baby's name right there, that's all I can see.
Chow, who appeared in court for a bond hearing Tuesday, initially telling investigators he believed the teen was also armed. The sheriff confirming a gun was recovered near Carmack Belton's body.
He just said, we chased him. My son said he had a gun. I took aim and I shot him. I mean, it was pretty simple by him explanation, but he never said the gun was pointed at him or his son. He never said that he was in danger. Never felt like his son's life was in danger. And that's the standards you have to have in order to use deadly force.
Community reaction leading to officers now standing guard outside the store's property.
Regardless of what happens in the community, you cannot take the law into your own hand. You don't have the right as a citizen to violate another citizen's property.
While others reflect on the young life lost.
It could have been your child. It could have been your loved one who walked in and didn't come home. It makes me emotional. It makes me angry. It makes me upset.
Valerie Castro joins us now in studio. Valerie, what else can you tell us about this convenience store owner?
So, Ellison, the Sheriff's Department says over the last 5 years, there have been hundreds of calls of service to this location for things like shoplifting, assault, and robbery. Records show that in 2018, Robert Chow was accused of shooting a shoplifter who assaulted him. That person survived. And in 2015, the department says Chow confronted another shoplifter who then threatened to shoot Chow. Chow was accused of shooting at that person's vehicle 6 times. No one was hurt in that incident, and Chow was not charged in either case. We should note we reached out to Chow's family for any statement on his behalf, but have not heard back.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we are back, and those two news clips fall under the category of fair use. So let's get ready to go in. As you see, this story takes place in South Carolina, Columbia, South Carolina, and this took place on this past weekend, which was last Sunday. Now, Mr. Belton, I guess he went in the cooler, picked up some water bottles, but he put them back. And so this Asian store owner, even though he put the bottles back, decides to have a verbal confrontation with him and then chase him outside. And then all because he thinks he saw a gun or whatever it is, even though the gun was not pointed at him or aimed at him, decides to shoot him in his back. Now, I believe that shooting somebody in the back is the worst and most cowardice thing you could ever, ever do. It would be different if Mr. Belton pulled a weapon or Mr. Chow feared for his life, but no, he didn't. He shot him in the back, and Mr. Chow was wrong, because you could even hear the sheriff, Leon Lott, say that there is no evidence that Mr. Belton shoplifted. He was falsely accused. You know, this eerily reminds me of the Latasha Harlins case that took place in Los Angeles back in the early 90s, a year or two before the Rodney King riots, because she was also shot by a Korean store worker, Soon John Doo, after falsely being accused of stealing a bottle of orange juice, which she did not do. And the worst part is, the Asian store owner got off. All the time, at least for the last couple of years. You know, we've been hearing all kinds of stuff about Stop Asian Hate. And you got certain idiots like Juju Chang, who always want to perpetrate the fraud and tell this big lie that it's black people who are perpetrating crimes against Asians. And, you know, she wants to say all kinds of stuff like, if you see a crime against someone who's Asian, then silence is violence and silence is consent. Now, but, you know, when the shoe is on the other foot, when it's the Asian person who does something to a black person, you don't hear Juju Chang talking about this. You had all kinds of rallies, especially over the last 3 years. Because many of y'all know that we have been in a pandemic for the last 3 years. Because COVID-19, you know, it did come from Wuhan, China. So some people called it the China virus and the Kung flu. And because it did come from China, they were committing acts of violence against Chinese and Asian people. So therefore, because even in Chicago they had one. You had all these rallies talking about the Stop Asian Hate rally. But that is one rally out of all the rallies and protests that I have gone to in my day. That is one rally that I had absolutely, positively, no desire to attend. Because, you see, just because some incidents happen to Korean and Chinese and Asian people, you had all of America coming out in full force to support them. And they have only been, I guess, persecuted because of the COVID-19 virus for the last 3 years. But the same groups of people, even Asians, will not come out and support black people for their quest of freedom and liberation. You had people, you know, idiots like Joseph the Jackass Biden and James Nigger Clyburn, who's supporting the Asian hate crime bill. But people like Senator James Clyburn, which of course I will probably be doing a video about possibly in the next week or two, supported Asians, but has absolutely nothing to say. Well, no, let me take that back. I'm saying too many words. He had a whole lot to say when it came down to reparations for black people. He says that it will never happen. You will never get it. And this is a black senator. And this crime took place in his home state of South Carolina. But no, James Nigga Jim Bojangles Clyburn and Joseph the Jackass Biden are very, very quiet about the death of Mr. Belton, but had a whole lot to say about Asian hate. Kamala Harris is very quiet about the death of Mr. Belton, but had a whole lot also to say about Asian hate. So, black people, for the last few years, have been going to Stop Asian Hate rallies, supporting Asians, but Asians, they're not supporting us in our quest for liberty and for freedom. So why should we support them? No Asian is standing up and saying that this is wrong. Just like Asians back then in the 90s in Los Angeles were not standing up and saying that the death of Latasha Harlins was wrong and that the beating of Rodney King was wrong. No Asian stood up and said that it was an injustice. But yet, a whole lot of black people, you know, stand by these people. You know, we need to stop. cannot believe it. In 2023, a young black boy falsely accused, he was falsely accused of shoplifting and then shot in the back. The most evil and most wickedest, most cowardly thing you could ever do is shoot someone in the back. And Mr. Chow's son also helped to perpetrate this crime, but they're only charging the father. They also need to charge the son as well, because the son is just as responsible as the father, because he was also there. And now that this has happened, you saw what they said in the news clips. I guess a whole bunch of protesters got upset and then broke out the windows and then broke in the store and stole items, turned over cabinets and turned over shelves. And now the sheriff wants to say it's just looting. And then in the second clip, you have some kind of black nigga up there talking about that it doesn't give, just because certain things go on, it doesn't give regular citizens the right to take the law into their own hands. I get so tired of black people pointing their finger at other black people, but this same black person who's talking a news clip is not pointing his finger at Mr. Chow. Somebody should have been telling him not to take the law into his own hands. How evil and how barbaric is that? All because you think somebody is shoplifting. And so what? Big deal. Even if a person were shoplifting, let's keep it here, it gives him no right to end up pulling out a weapon and shooting this man in the back. Even if that were happening. Because only thing that we are talking about here is this property. You know, stuff that could easily be replaced. So what if somebody has shoplifted a bottle of orange juice? So what if somebody shoplifted a bag of potato chips? So what if somebody shoplifted a couple of bottles of water? It's stuff that can be replaced. And now they're making a big deal, all because they have to board up the business and you have a whole bunch of police who have to stand out there now because they don't want his business to be torn up like the protesters were doing. Only thing we're talking about here, and only thing I see, which is really misplaced anger, by the way, only thing that people are upset about is property, but not dealing with life that can never be replaced. Property through insurance or whatever can be replaced. Bottles of water can be replaced. Bottles of orange juice can be replaced. But once you take somebody's life, that's all. That's it. It's over for that man. This is all we're talking about. This is all that the sheriff was saying, that it's just looting, you know. It's just looting. What is this rioting? Just looting. What does that have to do with the death of this young man? Excuse me, sir. Excuse me. Mr. Lott. It has a whole lot to do with the death of that man. Because people are outraged. And people are getting tired in this country of being shot, being arrested, being hurt, or whatever it is, all over something so, so small, over something so petty. And it's not only this. This particular store owner has had a record of this kind of behavior. Shooting somebody and him getting off. And the thing is, anytime he had a problem, he always got off, which only made him more emboldened to go and do it again and again and again. And the only thing black people can do in this case is just stand behind Asians in their problems, when not a single Asian person has stood up for us. We have allowed administrations, even like the administration of Joseph Biden, do any and everything for everyone else in this country except for us, who are Black American people who can trace our backgrounds to the killing fields of the American South. Joseph Biden has done everything to uphold and enforce the rights for LGBTQ citizens, tried to uphold abortion, trying to protect immigrants' rights, which is a problem deeply that we share here in Chicago. How the Chicago City Council voted the other day to award $51 million to immigrants who have illegally come into this country, but yet will not take care of homeless citizens and homeless veterans who are living on Chicago streets, mainly Black people, because Black people here in the city of Chicago make up 76% of the homeless. Joseph Biden has done everything to protect Asians, helping to sign the Asian hate crime law. But this same idiot, who a whole lot of you stupid, ignorant, hell-bound, hell-deserving people voted for, will not do something as simple as help to pass the George Floyd Policing Act. He has not dealt with trying to help us get a law for reparations, not put in police reform, not done anything, not one noteworthy thing for Black people who were his main voting base. But some of you stupid, ignorant Black people still keep on putting the same Democrats in who have turned their behinds in your face, who have not done anything for you. So we see other people being taken care of and being helped, but us as Black people are in this country are not being helped. So at this point, the way I'm feeling, especially after this, until we get something, and until we can stand as a strong Black nation, we need to withdraw our help and our support from everyone else. So right now, this Mr. Chow has been charged with murder. And I do hope that this trial, or this case goes to trial, and I hope and pray that he's found guilty, just like the killers of Ahmaud Arbery, and that he does go to prison. So, I think I'm about to end this whole thing, because I think I could go on and on and on, because you can see I'm very, very passionate about this here thing. So, right now, I believe I'm going to park this plane right here. And if anybody liked this video, please do me a favor. Give me a thumbs up. I greatly appreciate it. And please tune in next time for another episode of Roosevelt Sounds Off. And until the next video, this has been your friend, brother, and humble servant, Roosevelt, saying peace and blessings to all of you and your families. And most of all, justice for Cyrus Chermack Belton. Peace. Have a very good weekend.